Turn on the lights in the office.
Okay, turning three lights on.
Bubble Cloud, when used in watch face mode, changes the swipe behavior of your Wear OS watch. Instead of switching watch faces, you can swipe right to directly access the app drawer. You can also control screen brightness and even ambient dimming along the way. You can swipe vertically to show or hide the peak cord that my app brought back into Wear 2.9 and later. As you've seen it in the beginning of this video, I now added a new function to the left swipe. I call it Quick Swipe Panel. Google Assistant is the default setting, but you can assign any other app. For example, here's a cool application if you use Wearable Widgets. Long pressing its bubble, you can scroll down to the command assigned to Quick Swipe Panel. I select it, press OK, and now this way you can have real home screen widgets on your watch face. How cool is that? You can also assign a folder. If you want to split your apps between the two sides of the watch face, just move some of your bubbles into a folder. I show it in a separate video. And assign the folder. And now, swipe right for the regular app drawer, swipe left for the folder. And you are not even limited to only your watch apps. This is how we can assign tasker tasks. Look, it is fired on the phone. Or smart home control bubbles. Night, turn the lamp on. Or even bubbles which start apps on the phone. Well, starting Gmail probably doesn't make much sense though. To restore swipe to search, go to settings and under quick swipe panel, choose voice search. Since Google Assistant now speaks out loud, I have also added easy access to volume controls along the way. Tap the icon on the top to adjust alarm and notification volumes too. The standard watch face functions are still there, but you first have to tap on the active watch face to get to them. Then you can swipe horizontally to change face, swipe up for your notifications, swipe down for quick settings, and long press to access Bubble Cloud settings. Wear OS does not normally allow watch faces to detect and change swipe functionality. Bubble Cloud achieves this by adding a special layer over the watch face. We can toggle the overlay by tapping in the center of the watch face. You can move the hands behind the bubbles if you tap near the edges instead of the center. Android version Oreo and later gives us this permanent warning about Bubble Cloud displaying over other apps. They don't tell you, but fortunately, this notification can also be permanently hidden. Just press and hold on the warning, and when you see the system notifications control screen, turn off the switch there. Be careful, tapping this notification takes you to the settings, which denies the permission for Bubble Cloud to display its overlay. We need that permission, so long press. And when you see the system notification screen, then turn off the switch. You can balance out all the negativity my app is getting with a 5-star review in the Play Store. I really need your help in this. Using the quick link under the What's New command, it will really take only 5 seconds to leave a 5-star rating. You're also welcome to subscribe to my YouTube channel. And please like this video if you found it useful,
and enjoy the bubbles.